Gary, you didn't make a video last week.
What the hell?
Literally, a good friend of mine, shout out, Manny, buddy, texted me this morning and said, Gary, make a video. I said, aight. And I do apologize, I said I would start making videos once a week again, but I've been a little busy. I'm in a play, that's why. Who asked? I'm in a play with some other friends at my church, and if it looks like I'm wearing eyeliner, it's because I don't know how to get it off. Help. But it's called Murder is in the Air, or Murder's in the Air. I've been having a lot of fun. Doing some acting, and it's an easy role, I think. But a lot of people have been really happy with what I've been doing. I'm not much of an actor, but you know. I've impressed somebody. Today, I felt hard pressed to talk about something that is very important to me, and that is the power. Positivity. Being positive comes very natural to me. I'm very much an optimist. I wake up almost every day like, let's get this. Let's do this. Everything is awesome. Maybe not every day. There's some days where I do wake up like, oh crap, I don't want to be up, I don't want to be awake. But but being positive, it comes natural to me, but also it's been something I've been trying to really unleash, if that makes sense. So, like my friend texting me this morning, saying, hey, make a video, because he knows my passion for it, he knows my goals for making these videos, and he recognized that I didn't make one last week. So through the phone, through text message, punched me in the face, said, hey man, get to work. I bet some of you are wondering, Gary, I'm not naturally an optimist. How do I exude positivity like you do? Generally, that's how people talk right here. I'm the only person here in Springfield that talks like this. Oh gosh! Well, here's some simple things that I think you can do to just start naturally putting off more of a positive vibe. Because what does this planet need more than anything nowadays? It's most certainly positive vibes. First one, easy one, smile. Just smile more often. Greet people as if they're other human beings and their life matters. Even if in your mind you're saying, get out of my way, your life doesn't matter, die. Don't do that to people. There's no reason to do that to people. Just, you don't even have to say anything. Just when you see someone, just crack a smile. Just give a nod. But you know, and more times than not, people will nod back. And I mean, I wouldn't say this is a bad neighborhood, but it's certainly a rougher neighborhood. But hey, power positivity, am I right? Am I right? I just dabbed, and now I feel like all my positivity is left in my body. But that's just an easy one. Even if you don't want to, and you might be thinking, well, that's not very honest. You'll find yourself being a little more positive the more you smile. It's just kind of a natural reaction. You smile, oh, hey. Things aren't so bad. Even when things are bad, it's okay to be positive. Hey, another thing. Another thing that can help you be positive, wake up and think positive thoughts. Think of something that just generally makes you happy as you wake up. Get up and maybe do a few push-ups or, you know, get your favorite breakfast ready. Start your day off on the right friggin' foot, and most of the time, the rest of your day will follow suit. Or you'll be able to handle the rest of the day and crap it. Crap it throws at you. In a better light. That can be anything. You could have a book of different, you know, sayings or positive things. You could have songs that just naturally make you feel happy and positive, turn that sucker on and get your day started. Start your day the positive way. I'm gonna get on somebody's nerves. Positive! Thirdly, if you feel yourself thinking negative thoughts, if something just kinda happened, you know, some random guy off the street comes up and says, "Hey man, you have fat toes. You got fat toes, son. You need to lose some fat toe weight. Toe fatty." Ignore them. Especially if you don't know them. If they're just some random strangers, like, "Okay, buddy, wearing shoes. Clearly can't see my toe fatness." Okay. I'm not saying so much saying ignore negativity, because there's some negative things in life that you do need to address. You don't want to stuff that stuff down. Trust me, it's not good for you. But you don't have to take random strangers' crap. Alright? If they don't know you and they're just coming up to you, freaking out about your toes, you don't have to take their crap. What was the point of this one? Oh yeah, when negative thoughts, when negative things happen, take it in stride, take it head on. If you've already followed the first two steps, you've already started your day off positively, you've smiled at 10 or 15 people, you're feeling the vibe, you're going super saiyan positive, who knows what you could do for someone else. Maybe someone else is just feeling those positive vibes. Maybe someone else is trying to get to that Super Saiyan positive themselves. Maybe they're just at Super Saiyan Kai 10. Dragon Ball Z references. 90s kid! Is that 90s or 2000s? I'm gonna claim it's 90s. It's ours now. For example, this morning, I went to McDonald's. Now, I don't usually go to McDonald's. Especially if it's not breakfast. Their non-breakfast food tastes great, sure. It's made to taste great. Hurts my stomach. Since I've started eating healthier, losing weight, McDonald's food makes my stomach want to crawl out, pull out a knife, and stab me to death, and then crawl back in and die along with me. That's what it does. But their breakfast is... I was on my way. I went into work when I didn't need to. Some call that a negative. I was able to turn it into a positive. I'll tell you that. Actually, yeah, I'll tell you that. Near the end of the video, after I finish this one. I went into the drive-thru and I ordered my sandwich. And the lady at the second window said, "Hey, baby, how you doing?" Handed me my food. I was like, "Dang, girl, that positivity." I was like, "You have a good morning." She's like, "Yeah, baby, you too." And I was like, "Oh!" I was already a Super Saiyan 1 positive. She jettisoned me into Super Saiyan 2 positive! Only one thing that could probably send me into Super Saiyan positive 3. That's none of your business. But yeah, she just decided that early in the morning, which, you know, I don't know this woman's life story, you know. She didn't seem like a rougher character. She didn't seem like she had been through a lot, but she most certainly could have been. She was an elderly. She was a black woman, I'd say probably 40s, maybe 50s, somewhere around there. And she was just exploding with positivity. And she let that leak into my car with my bag of food. I could have come up with a better analogy than that. But I'm keeping it in! And she, you know, who knows what her story could have been, but she helped someone who was already positive reach another level of positivity. This all happened before 9 o'clock. You probably can't see that. This isn't that definition. Camera. Also, a lot of people who might be having a negative day could intercept those positive vibes that you throw out. That smile that you just smile at and think, "Oh, the world isn't as crappy as I thought." You never know. Never know if you could have saved a life or not. Whoa, that got serious. That's the power of positivity, though. Sometimes things get serious. But Before I go, I want to tell the story of why I went into work when I didn't need to. So, where I work at, I think I said in the last video, which was 2 weeks ago, sorry! I work at a retirement village, where it's like, they're independent living seniors. We provide a few services for them, but they kind of live on their own. Sometimes they have homemakers come in, or they have a nurse come in and help them with stuff. They do all that themselves. But I work at the front desk 1 week, and I drive the bus the next week. It's just a 15-passenger bus. They sign up to go places, and I take them there. Today, they usually go to Hy-Vee Bingo. Hy-Vee Bingo. But I forgot, or I wasn't even thinking. Today was the first. And the first Wednesday of the month, they're going to go to Hy-Vee Bingo. But I went in, and I talked to our service coordinator. Was there, and I've got a good friendship with this lady, and she's a really nice lady. I've known her since I was in like junior high or something like that. Anyways, we have a resident. I'm not going to name names because that would be inappropriate. But this resident, their health is just out of nowhere. Well, not so much out of nowhere, just declined. It's cancer. A lot of weight. They're getting ready to move the stuff out because they're not thinking he's going to be with us much longer. Where did that positivity go, Gary? Chill. And now, to tell you a little bit about myself, I'm a believer. I'm a Christian. I believe in Jesus Christ, you know, rose from the dead, all that good stuff. You know the story. I know the story. Mel Gibson made a movie out of it. I'm struggling with that because this man isn't a believer, and that's perfectly fine. Christians shouldn't force their beliefs on anybody. Tell the good news. Tell the people about it. Hey, this is what I believe. I think it's pretty darn cool. If they say, no thanks, dog. I'm good, but thanks for sharing. Just be there. Be the example of Jesus that Jesus has called you to be. Which is a nice person. Don't force things on people. Now, our service coordinator, she's a believer as well. And she's really wanted this resident to believe, because what we believe, with what we believe as Christians, if we didn't tell people, we would truly be awful people. There's a lot of people out there who think Christians are awful people. We can discuss that in another video. And I just, you know, she's much older than me, not much older than me. She's still a very good looking lady at her age. Didn't mean to be weird. She's struggling because she wanted to tell him at least one more time, you know, hey, this is what I believe, and I want you to believe this too, so when you pass, you can go to heaven, because that's what we believe. I told her, I said, well, that's simple for me. It's, we believe that with what we believe in, with what we believe is the truth, if we didn't tell the people we love about this, not be very good people. We'd be hiding an awesome thing from the world. That's not what Jesus calls us to do. Again, don't force it on people. You can't force it on people. You shouldn't force it on people. That would be wrong. But tell people. Yeah. So that was today's video. I hope you got something out of it. Or you just like looking at my pretty face. I've been having a lot of fun. I had a lot of fun last year making videos. I'm excited to get back into it, make some again this year. Hopefully I can get a different camera. Not that this one's doing great. Positivity. But I'd like to have a little more. You know, some a little better for different videos, because I like to do some challenge videos again with some of my friends down here in Springfield. Thanks a lot for watching. See you next week. Yeah, I'll see you next week. And if I don't post a video next week, feel free to text me. If you have my number, text me and say, hey, Gary, where's the video? I mean, and you probably don't even watch, but that's fine. Thanks for hanging out with me this morning in my kitchen.